When you work with a glove box, you learn that it has a huge appetite for nitrogen. To feed the beast, we use a very large stainless steel 230 liters liquid nitrogen door. This video will show you how to change that tank once it's empty. Let's take a look at our little tank farm. If the big tank is empty, there is a smaller K-sized cylinder that can be used as a backup. The first step is to close off the big tank. Working inwards, close the valve on the regulator that connects to the big tank's hose, followed by the valve on the tank itself. To open up the small tank, we should work outwards. First, open the tank, followed by the valve on the regulator. In general, I work inwards when closing the tank, the gas tanks, and outwards when opening gas tanks. One last safety issue. With these dewars, it's possible that the lines can be frozen with a large amount of gas flow, say during purging. If you have a valve that is turned all the way open and it then gets cold, it could be frozen in the open position if the valve changes size with an extreme change of temperature. For this reason, I will open a valve all the way, but then back it slightly so it's free to move even if there is a large temperature swing. We've ensured that nitrogen will keep flowing even once the big tank has been removed. So it's now time to disconnect it and get it down to the building's dock to be taken away. Grab a wrench of the appropriate size and type. My preference is to use a fixed, open-ended wrench instead of the adjustable wrench. With your wrench in hand, loosen the hose connection at the big tank. After a while, it should be loose enough to remove by hand. If you wish, let the hose hang from the regulator so you have a clear path to move the tank. Assuming the tank is on four wheels, it can roll easily. Pull the tank away from the wall using the top bar. But once it's away from the wall, you should use the bar at the bottom to drag it around. Head down to the dock and grab the new one. David brought the new big tank up to the lab and is ready to put it into place. Thanks, David! Make sure that you've directed the gas nozzle in the tank towards the regulator so that you can easily connect it to the flexible stainless steel hose. The correct nozzle is identified with a sticker or metal tag. With the nozzle in the right direction, connect the hose using a threaded connection. You can start it with your hand and then use the wrench to finish the job. When the tank connected, you should close the auxiliary gas tank first. The big tank can finally be opened. If you connected the hose correctly, you won't hear any hissing sound of gas escaping through the threads. The system is back up and running. What a time to be alive!